Welcome to the BodyMetrix Pro Training Tutorial for Mac OSX. We want to take this opportunity to thank you for your purchase, and we're confident you'll find the BodyMetrix to be a valuable assessment tool for your business and your clients' health, fitness, and wellness goals. This tutorial is designed to assist you in learning how to ensure accurate and consistent body composition measurements are taken. From the BodyView home screen, you can create an unlimited number of client profiles, open existing client profiles, or use the BodyMetrix system in demonstration mode. To create a client profile, click on the new profile icon and enter the client's first and last name. You have the option to create an ID, which can be useful for environments that require a level of anonymity or restricted access. Next, enter your client's birth date by highlighting and typing the month, day, and year, or by using the up and down arrows. Select the appropriate gender, male or female, from the drop-down menu, and then select the appropriate athletic type, non-athletic, athletic, or elite. These athletic types are based on your first impression of the client's physical appearance. Individuals who are very noticeably overweight or obese should be designated as non-athletic. Virtually everyone else can be categorized as athletic, with the exception of clients who are extremely lean. The elite setting is generally appropriate for these individuals, as they typically have a low body fat percentage, good muscle definition, and they exercise regularly. They usually don't have a noticeable fold of fat that you can grab or pinch in the abdomen or waist. Examples would include marathon runners, bodybuilders, and certainly clients with six-pack abs. It's important to know that the athletic typing does not explicitly enter into the calculation of body fat percentage, but rather, it's a helpful tool for our software to help correctly interpret the ultrasound signal and identify the true fat-muscle interface. We'll review this in more detail when we discuss how to accurately measure and calculate body fat percentage. If you're not quite sure of which setting to choose from, the athletic setting is always a good place to start. You can also associate clients into different groups by typing in the name of the group. For example, maybe you're having a New Year's boot camp or a Biggest Loser's weight loss challenge and so forth. This gives you the ability to view numeric statistics of individuals within a group by navigating to the Profiles field from your Apple menu at the top left of the screen and selecting Group Summary. Next, select the unit of measurement in pounds and inches, or kilograms and centimeters, and then enter your client's weight as well as their height. You can also input an email address, which gives you the ability to send clients their body composition assessment reports. Select the Create button, and you're now ready to begin measuring. Select your body composition formula from the drop-down menu here on the left. There's a wide variety of choices for both males and females depending on what your methodology is, but the Jackson and Pollock formulas are commonly used and widely seen in academic research. Generally speaking, the 3-site Jackson and Pollock is a good formula for males, and the 4-site Jackson and Pollock formula for females, as it includes the waist measurement, which correlates strongly with risk levels for chronic disease, including diabetes, heart disease, and stroke. The first measurement site is the thigh, and clicking on the question mark button brings up a description of the site point, how to apply the gel, and the measurement technique with the BodyMetrix ultrasound device. Apply a dime-sized amount of gel to the head of the BodyMetrix device as shown. Next, click on the measure point button, place the device on the site point, and without pressing the button, spread a thin layer of gel by moving the device up and down approximately 1 inch. To make a measurement, press the button on the device and move the device up and down at a comfortable speed, making sure to stay within the 1-inch area for 2 to 5 seconds, and then let go of the button. You'll take a second measurement, so repeat the same process by again pressing the button and moving it up and down for 2 to 5 seconds. You're moving the device 1/4 inch to 1/2 inch on either side of the measurement point. This technique is called averaging, which gives you a signal here in the measurement data graph displaying clearly defined characteristic peaks. The first strong peak is generally the fat muscle interface, which lines up nicely between the yellow area representing fat thickness and the pink area representing muscle. The fat thickness is displayed here at 7.2 millimeters. The second peak represents a thin layer of connective tissue known as fascia within the muscle tissue. Next, we'll demonstrate measuring without using the averaging technique. In this example, we'll press the button for a fraction of a second without moving the BodyMetrix device. The resulting measurement data graph shows an unaveraged signal with many fine, thin peaks representing various tissue structure. Keep in mind that the BodyMetrix transmits a narrow beam of ultrasound that detects tissue structure along that beam, so it's very important to move the device and average the signal because it eliminates the fine structure, which is not of interest when measuring fat layer thickness, leaving you with clearly defined signal peaks and clean interfaces like the fat muscle interface and muscle bone interface. There may be occasions where the software prompts you to take a third measurement because the first two measurements taken disagreed by more than 10%, or the device was not flush and perpendicular on the skin. Let's repeat the measurement using the averaging technique to show you the difference. Click and highlight the chest side point, then the measure point button. It's not necessary to wipe the device clean between measurements, but you may need to add a small amount of gel to ensure that it slides easily on the skin. Spread the gel within the optimal area, and using the averaging technique, slide the BodyMetrix device diagonally back and forth a quarter of an inch to a half an inch on either side of the side point. The fat thickness is 9.2 millimeters, and the first large characteristic peak is the fat muscle interface between the yellow and pink regions when we analyze the graph. Next, we'll click and highlight the waist. Apply the gel in the same manner as your previous measurements, spreading a thin layer, moving the device side to side, beginning 1 inch to the right of the umbilicus or belly button. You'll use the averaging technique again, and when you're ready to measure, press the button and slide the device side to side at a comfortable speed for 3 to 4 seconds and let go of the button. Repeat the same procedure for the second measurement, and then look at your measurement data graph. This graph illustrates a very important point with regard to the waist measurement. The true fat muscle interface is not necessarily the first strong peak. Remember, the athletic type settings act as a helpful tool for the software to choose the most likely peak representing the true fat muscle interface and does not explicitly enter into the calculation of body fat percentage. Had you selected the elite setting when you created your client's profile, the software will choose the first strong characteristic peak in the waist measurement here at approximately 6 millimeters. This makes sense as elite individuals' fat thicknesses normally range between 3 to 10 millimeters in most cases. In analyzing the measurement data graph, 25 millimeters is a great reference point to consider when measuring a client's waist, as it's equal to 1 inch of fat, or a noticeable fold of fat that you can grab or pinch in the waist. 8 millimeters is about a third of an inch, which is a thinner layer you could possibly poke, but not a significant fold. In looking at your client's waist, it should be very easy to see if they have considerably more or less than 25 millimeters or an inch. Using this helpful reference, it's clear that the software did in fact choose the appropriate characteristic peak at 18.8 millimeters, the true fat muscle interface for this measurement. In examining the measurement data graph further, the first peak for this waist measurement actually represents a thin layer of connective tissue within the fat known as a fascia. The fascia separates two distinctive fat layers in the waist. Superficial adipose tissue, or SAT, is the layer between the skin and this first fascia peak. And the deeper adipose tissue, or DAT, is the layer between the fascia peak and the true fat muscle interface here at 18.8. The deep adipose tissue is the metabolically active fat, and it correlates highly with chronic diseases such as diabetes, heart disease, and stroke. With elite individuals, the superficial and deep adipose layers tend to merge together and form one layer. However, as the fat thickness in the waist grows due to lack of exercise or poor diet, the fat then separates into these two compartments or layers of fat, superficial and deep adipose tissue. The importance of analyzing your measurement data graph is critical to ensure accurate measurement readings in the waist. Let's consider one scenario where you accidentally set the athletic type to elite and the software chose this first peak around 6 millimeters after taking your measurements. Using a reference of 25 millimeters, we know that 6 millimeters is less than a third of an inch of fat, but for this individual, again, it's obvious that they have a noticeable fold in the waist, so the most likely characteristic peak is in fact the strong signal at 18.8 millimeters. Now what you can do is you can manually override the automatic peak detection in the algorithm by clicking on the peak at 18.8 millimeters. This forces the software to use this peak as the true fat-muscle interface. There may be instances where the ultrasound signal fluctuates despite having the correct athletic typing, especially with individuals who are extremely sedentary or obese. However, don't panic. You can always override any measurement if necessary, so please be sure to examine your measurement data graph to ensure the appropriate peak has been selected before saving your data. Once you've completed your analysis, the true body fat percentage is automatically calculated and displayed under the side point description box here. One of the most exciting features of the BodyMetrix is the ability to render cross-sectional images with the scan feature. Scanning gives you the ability to target specific areas of interest and examine, quantify, and track both fat and muscle layer thicknesses. It's an excellent tool which validates the effectiveness of diet and exercise and provides tangible proof of change, showing evolution, progress, or regression. Scans can be used while in demonstration mode or within an existing client's profile. To start a scan, click on the Scan tab at the top right of your body view screen. You'll then type in the name of the area below the image, for example, left bicep or right thigh and so forth. This can be useful to compare scans to the left or right sides of the body to see differences in muscle development and fat thickness distribution. In this example, I'll go ahead and type left bicep. Next, apply about a quarter-sized amount of gel to the head of the BodyMetrix device as shown. With the arm in a relaxed position, spread the gel from approximately 1 inch above the peak of the bicep in the center of the muscle down to the elbow approximately 3 to 4 inches without pressing the button. You're moving the device up and down to ensure it will glide smoothly on the skin so it doesn't stick or bind. When you're ready to start scanning, click on the Enable Scan button and go back to your starting point approximately 1 inch above the peak of the bicep at the center of the muscle, press the button, and with the device flush and perpendicular on the skin, slowly drag the device downward in one direction. Stopping at the bend of the elbow. The speed you're moving the device is approximately 4 to 5 seconds in most cases. As you do this, you see a cross-sectional picture form on the screen. The default image is rendered in grayscale, very similar to an X-ray image, but you can uncheck the box to see it in blue scale as well. The left side of the image represents the starting point of your scan above the midpoint on the bicep, and the right side is the end of the scan at the bend of the elbow. In examining this image, we see both white and light blue bands of signal, which represent strong ultrasound reflections or echoes that identify a change in tissue structure and occur at different tissue borders or interfaces, for example, the fat-muscle interface or the muscle-bone interface. You can drag a small rectangle from various points on the signal to the top of the image to see different fat thicknesses throughout the scan, shown below the image here in millimeters. What you're also seeing in this image is a region here which represents the first muscle group in the bicep known as the bicep brachii, and the second muscle group here known as the biceps brachialis. The last white band of signal here at approximately 40 millimeters is a reflection off of the humerus bone, and represents where the muscle actually meets the top of the bone or the muscle-bone interface. The distance from the fat muscle interface signal to the top of the bone gives you the total muscle thickness in millimeters. One of the things you can do is track these interfaces, which allows you to quantify both fat and muscle layer thicknesses. To do this, click on the Track Interface button, and then using your mouse, place your cursor on the fat muscle interface signal, positioning it in the center of the signal as much as possible, and click. You can adjust the tracking by setting your own data points by moving your cursor to the desired area and clicking again. Once you're satisfied with the tracking, click the Stop Tracking button. Next, you can track the muscle-bone interface, where the muscle meets the top of the bone and adjust it as needed. We have now quantified both fat and muscle thickness. The white signal we see within the muscle typically represents intramuscular fat or other tissue structures such as connective tissue or veins possibly, so you can look at the quality of that muscle as well. You can save the image by selecting the Save Image button and compare changes in fat and muscle thickness by selecting the Compare tab. You can search for the scan area and date from the drop-down menu here on the left, possibly a baseline image of a targeted area, and then compare later images here on the right to show changes in both fat and muscle thickness. This validates the effectiveness of your client's diet and exercise and provides actual proof of progress, evolution, or regression, and shifts the focus away from scale weight. This brings us to the end of our training overview. By selecting Help at the top of the page, you can review this video, view a technical presentation, or access our user's guide. If you require additional support, please contact us at 925-606-7044 or email us at support@intellimetrix.com. Thank you.